Okay, in this video, we're going to see how to use the comparison theorem to show that if this improper integral converges or not. And to do so, I need to come up with something that I know much better first. So let me just write it down. And I tell my students that you have to write down these three steps. Put down what you know, and then do the check, and then in the end, draw your conclusion. So let's see how we can come up with some proper improper integral that we can actually use and we know much better. One of the ways to do it is, of course, let's just consider the highest power of x on the top and likewise the highest power of x on the bottom. Just ignore the plus 1 and the minus 1. Just so you guys know, when you have that extra plus 1 or the minus 1 in the integral becomes so much harder to integrate, right? Just ignore the other terms. Just pay attention to the dominating part, like this. And I'm going to work this out. This is 2 to infinity. Here we have x over. This is square root of x cubed dx. And let's simplify this. We know that this is the same as the integral 2 to infinity. This is x to the first power over, I can change that to x to the 3 over 2 power. 3 over 2. 3 over the index 2, like this. Dx. And when we subtract the power, 1 minus 3 half, we get negative 1 half. That means we can have this as the integral from 2 to infinity, 1 over x to the positive 1 half power, like that. And when you have this, you actually know about this, because you see that this right here is the p, right? This is the p integral for the p test. P right here is 1 half. And this is the type 1 improper integral. When p is less than or equal to 1, which we have 1 half, it is less than 1, right? It is less than or equal to 1. This will tell us this improper integral actually diverges. Okay? So now once you have this, here we are going to do the check. And as what I wanted to tell you guys, put down the improper integral that you're trying to do on the left hand side. So let me write it down here. 2 to infinity, x plus 1 over square root of x cubed minus 1 dx. And put down the 1 that you know much better on the right hand side. And we are going to make a comparison. And perhaps I will just put it down this form. 1 over x to the 1 half power dx, like this. Remember, this right here diverges. It diverges to positive infinity. We actually want to show that if this is bigger than or equal to this right here, if we can show this is bigger than infinity, of course, this is infinity as well. It's even a bigger infinity, right? So we want to show this inequality if it's true or not. And by the way, both of these right here are positive. You guys can check that out, but you can indicate that on your own right here on the side. Okay? All the terms right here are positive. And once again, a diverge is like, just like saying, if you meet somebody and you know this person is old, and if you can find somebody who's older than an old person, what can you say about this person? He is also old, right? So that's pretty much the idea. Anyway, let's do the algebraic check, because now we just have to worry about the function part. This is x plus 1 over square root of x cubed minus 1. I want to see if this is bigger than or equal to 1 over x to the 1 half on the interval 2 to infinity. Or you can also write for x is greater than or equal to 2. Doesn't matter, same thing. Perhaps I will do that. For x is greater than or equal to 2, because we go from 2 to infinity. Okay, everything is positive, as I indicated here. So I can cross multiply without changing the inequality symbol. And let me just do this times that, which is x to the 1 half times x plus 1. Multiply this and that. I don't know yet, so I'll put on a question mark. And then we have the x cubed minus 1. Well, I have the square root. I don't like that. Perhaps I'll square both sides. And you see, distribute the power in this case, you get x to the first, and then you have x plus 1 square. Is this greater than or equal to? Cancel this out, x cubed minus 1. Well, if you would like, you can do more algebra right here, right? Expand this, you have x in front. Expand it, you get x squared plus 2x plus 1. Is this greater than or equal to x cubed minus 1? If you would like, you can distribute x cubed plus 2x squared, right? And then plus x. Is this greater than or equal to x cubed minus 1? This is my question mark, by the way. I think so, because you can totally cancel out the x cubed on both sides. And you have 2x squared plus x. It is greater than or equal to, negative 1, because you have x is greater than or equal to 2. So this right here is now, you can convince people it has to be true, right? It has to be true. When you can find another person that's older than an old person that you already know, you can draw the conclusion this person is also old. So we can draw conclusion. And be sure you can only draw conclusion when you have a true inequality right here. If not, we have to go back and redo it. Anyway, I will tell you guys that this right here, let me write it down. This is how you write essays. Introduction, body paragraph, and conclusion. So I want to tell you guys that in proper integral, from 2 to infinity, x plus 1 over square root of x cubed minus 1 dx also diverges. Why? You can say by the comparison theorem with the divergent that you know, which is that 1 over x to the 1 half power dx. Right? That's it. So this is how you do the proof for improper integrals with the comparison theorem. In the end, if you want to be fancy, you can draw a box and shade this in. This is how the math people do it. So that's it.